Aloha, welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and in this video, we're going to review the types of nebulae that exist. A nebula is defined as a cloud of gas and dust that consists mostly of hydrogen. Typically, there are other trace elements that exist within the cloud, such as water, formaldehyde, alcohol, and other trace elements, but they're mostly consist of hydrogen. Now, before we dive into the different types of nebulae, let's go over the singular and plural versions of this word, just so there's no confusion. So when we talk about a nebula, that's when we're looking at one specific nebula. So that's a singular version of this word. But if we say nebulae, that means that is plural. So more than one nebula, we say nebulae. There are five main types of nebulae, and they can be broken down into two categories. The ones listed at the top, such as absorption, reflection, and emission, these are known to be diffuse nebulae, so they do not have a definitive shape. In fact, they're often named after objects that they resemble. The other types of nebulae include planetary nebulae and supernova remnants, and the shape of these nebulae are typically spherical in structure. Now let's review and take a look at what these different types of nebulae look like. So our first one that we're going to examine is called an absorption nebula. And the way this one works is that it is such a dense, dark cloud that light cannot pass through it. It almost absorbs that light that is passing through it. And the classic example of an absorption nebula is the Horsehead Nebula, which is located in Orion, right near the Belt and Sword. And as you can see, there's no definitive shape. It's not spherical. It can be considered to be asymmetrical. But many nebulae are named after what they resemble. And if you take a look at this, you can sort of see how it would resemble a horse's head. Another classic example of a dark nebula or absorption nebula is a snake nebula, and this one is located in the constellation called Ophiuchus, and you can just see here that this cloud of gas and dust is just so thick that light cannot pass through it. The next type of nebulae is called an emission nebulae, and these are clouds of gas and dust that are glowing brightly due to fluorescence. So inside this cloud of gas and dust, there are tiny stars that are starting to be born. And what this does is it heats up the cloud and it causes it to glow. And the Orion Nebula in the constellation of Orion is a classic example of an emission nebula. And where would you find this? If you would look at the belt stars of Orion right here, the Orion Nebula sits right in his sword. And there are other spectacular nebula right around the belt stars as well. In fact, this is where the Horsehead Nebula is as well. Here are some other great examples of emission nebulae. To the left, we have the North America Nebula. This is located in the constellation Cygnus, and as you probably notice, it does resemble the continent of North America. But even cooler on the right is called the Ghost Nebula, and this is located in the constellation Cepheus. And it's just so cool how you have this cloud, and inside of it you have a little baby star, and that star is starting to heat up the nebula, and it glows. And it does look ghost-like for sure. So again, another example of how we are naming things after what they resemble. And even here, these kind of look like little ghosts coming out as well. The third type of diffuse nebulae or irregular-shaped nebulae would be the reflection type. And this is unique in the sense that it is illuminated. This cloud of gas and dust is illuminated by the glow of nearby stars. And typically, reflection nebulae are more blue in color because the dust tends to scatter blue light more effectively than red. So typically, these nebulae are more blue in color, and the Pleiades star cluster, located in the constellation Taurus, is another classic example of this type of nebulae. This next nebula I'd like to share with you is called the Trifid Nebula, also known as Messier 20. And this one is very interesting because it is a rare combination of the three types of diffuse nebulae that exist. So when we're looking at this picture, we're looking towards the center of the Milky Way galaxy and right through the constellation Sagittarius. So I'm going to bring your attention to this area, and this is the part of the picture that we are going to zoom in, and this is what we find. So the Trifid Nebula shows each type of diffuse nebulae that exist. So the dark portions, all right in here, that is considered an absorption nebulae or a dark nebula. And then the pink areas all throughout here, this would be considered to be an emission nebula. And then up here, this bluish area is considered to be a reflection nebula. So again, the fact that these are all combined into one type is very, very interesting. And this is one of those few spots in the sky that just definitely attracts many different types of astronomers because you get to see three types in one specific astronomical object. So just to recap so far, we have explored the diffuse types of nebula, the ones that do not have a definitive shape, and those were absorption, reflection, and emission. Now let's go ahead and look at the types of nebulae that do have a definitive shape. Our first type of spherical nebulae are the planetary nebulae, but the name is slightly misleading because these types of nebulae have nothing to do with planets. And they were first named when William Herschel in 1785 observed these through a telescope, and he thought that they looked very similar to the spherical shape of a planet. So that's why they were named planetary nebulae. But in fact, this object is really a dying star in the end stages of its life, and this is eventually what will happen to our sun. So this star right here in the center is not truly a star anymore because it's not undergoing fusion. It's run out of hydrogen and helium and all the elements it was fusing at one time in its core, and this is all that's left. Is this little white dwarf star? It's the hot leftover core of a main sequence star, regular type star. And these outer layers are the gases that are being blown off the star, and they really have some beautiful shapes. So this is really at the end stages of the star, and typically at the end of the red giant phase, and you have this little white dwarf left in the center. So let's take a look at some other ones. This is the Eskimo Nebula right here in Gemini. You can probably see why it has that name because it definitely looks like an Eskimo with its hood up. And then we have the Dumbbell Nebula, and this is located in Vulpecula, which is known as a fox in the southern hemisphere. And if we were to go back to this one, this is known as the Cat's Eye Nebula in Draco the Dragon. The final type of nebulae that we will examine is called a supernova remnant, and these are some of the coolest looking nebulae that exist. So, how these form is that these are the leftover remains of a supernova explosion. And you can really just tell from this picture that this really looks like it was blown to smithereens. Everything is moving outwards from the center. And typically, within these supernova remnants, there are pulsars inside of there. So hot neutron stars that are spinning very, very rapidly and often send out radio signals. And the one that we're looking at here is called the Crab Nebula, located in Taurus. And let's take a look at where that would be. So if you have Orion right down here and you use the belt stars to help you find the V-shaped face of Taurus, And then you come down to the lower horn. The Crab Nebula is located right near the tip of the horn in Taurus the Bull. So, what's interesting about supernovas is that this is the celestial event that occurs when all the elements on the periodic table are created. Regular stars like our sun do not have the ability or the mass that they need in order to fuse together higher elements. And the largest element that any star could form is iron. And once iron starts to form inside of a star, it becomes unstable and the iron starts to absorb the energy, therefore causing it to be unstable. And then kaboom, that's when a supernova occurs. And this whole shell of clouds and gas and dust is still expanding to this day. And if you were to look up different types of pictures of supernova remnants, they really do have this spherical but also irregular structure in which it really just looks like it was blown up. Let's review the five different types of nebulae that exist and the two different categories that they are in. So all the nebulae that are listed at the top, those are irregular shaped nebulae. They're diffuse. They do not have a definitive shape. And if they do have a shape, sometimes their name will reflect that shape, like the Horsehead Nebula, which is considered to be a dark nebula in the sense that it's really absorbing the light that is surrounding it because the clouds are so thick that light cannot pass through. We also have reflection nebulae, and these are the ones that are reflecting the light that are coming from nearby stars. The dust that is located within the cloud is scattering the light, causing that blue color. And then the final diffuse type of nebula are emission nebulae, and these are ones that are glowing because the stars that are located inside here are starting to become hot, and it causes all the gas inside to glow due to fluorescence. Now we have this spherical type shape, and that one would be the planetary nebulae, and these are the nebulae that are dying. They're at the end of their life and they're just throwing off all the outer layers, but they have this very unique, sometimes almost a series of rings around rings with each other. And even though they're named planetary nebulae, they do not have anything to do with planets. They just inherited that name because at one time, astronomers thought it looked like a planet. And then finally, we have supernova remnants, and these are violent reactions of a dying star in which pretty much the whole thing was blown apart. Many different elements were created, and it also creates a super cool shape. And often there are little pulsars inside of here, little neutron stars that are spinning rapidly and giving off radio stars. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other interest about constellation or different types of celestial objects that exist out there, feel free to subscribe to my channel. And I encourage you to keep going outside, observing the stars, and then as you start to learn the sky, share what you have learned with others and inspire them to go outside as well. Thanks for watching.